Breaking news, ladies and gentlemen. Justin Prince has been fired. The man to my right, Mike Maz, has officially taken over as sports director at Fox 55. Mike, congratulations. Welcome to the team.
You wish. you know what the big guy would do if that were true. A, he would pound me into submission. Bang, 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 bang. And I would go down, down, down. Instead of being 5'8", I would become a minus 2'6".
He's not in here right now, so we don't have to worry about him. We kid, of course. He's Mike Maz, the play-by-play voice of the Fort Wayne TinCaps. Here, as always, to talk all things TinCaps baseball in TinChattin. And, Mike, let's not bury the lead here. We've been not begging, but politely asking on this segment all season for the San Diego Padres to bring some of their top talent to Fort Wayne. We hadn't really seen a lot of if you look at their top 30 prospect rankings, didn't have a lot of those guys on the roster at the beginning of the season or really for much of the season. And then last weekend, we finally got our wish. Three of the Padres' top 20 prospects. Of course, we're talking about Yeribiel Angeles, Brandon Valenzuela, and the headliner, Robert Hassell III. Mike, he was the first-round pick of the Padres in the 2020 draft, ranked third in their system, ranked top 50 overall. If you look at the rankings in all of baseball and the talent, pretty obvious the first time he stepped on the field at Parkview Field on Sunday.
There was a buzz in the ballpark last Sunday afternoon when those three players, they flew from California through the night. They did not get into Fort Wayne until the wee hours of Sunday morning. And yet there was a buzz. Robert Hassell III is the real deal.
Yeah.
He made his presence felt on the very first at-bat of the game last Sunday in the starting lineup in the leadoff spot playing in center field. He showed his quickness. He showed his speed, flagged down a fly ball hit into the alley, and he made it look easy. Now, he didn't get a hit on Sunday, but more to that a little bit later in our discussion.
Yeah.
But he has this... what's the term I'm looking for? Aura about him.
So, Mike, Robert Hassell III makes his debut on Sunday. Doesn't get a hit. Gets his first hit with the TinCaps on Tuesday. And then on Wednesday, does something that no one with this franchise will ever forget.
As you mentioned, Peter, his nickname is Bobby Barrels.
Which is a heck of a nickname, by the way.
He has it trademarked.
Smart kid.
If you didn't know that
yep.
already. And we saw a little bit of evidence on it on Sunday, though he did not get a hit. He hit the ball hard three times.
Yeah.
On Wednesday night, he became the second Fort Wayne Tin Cap and just the third player in Fort Wayne franchise history to hit three home runs in a game. And it's just a taste of what he can do and what we as fans of Fort Wayne Tin Caps hope we'll get to see more of. Not just in the final homestand of the year next week. Hopefully he'll be on the Fort Wayne roster at least at the start of 2022.
All right, so they call Robert Hassell III Bobby Barrels. I'm going to start calling Mike Maz Mike the Masher. You like that? If anybody out there has ever seen this man swing a driver on the golf course, you'll know why. Mike the Masher.
I wish I were younger sometimes. It dates me going back to my days as a caddy in suburban Detroit.
Mike smashed potatoes. I don't know, I'll come up with something better by next week.
You think of something and we'll put something together.
He is Mike Maz. That is just the name that he was given at birth, and he is kind enough once again to join us this evening. Mike, always appreciate your time.
Thank you, sir.
That'll do it for this week's edition of TinChattin. And as always, we'll be back same time, same place next week. Until then, please stick around. We got more Locker Room coming up after the break.